beautiful from the very.
Hey, 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 guys, we are back. This time we're repping the Bears. He has his little Bears. I have my big Bears, Forte. But he has on his little chain too. Y'all gotta excuse him. Well, don't really excuse him because he is who he want to be. But he has on his chain, and he will not let me take this chain off. This is like his thing. I don't know if it's from the videos that we watch, because I don't wear necklaces like that. I only got one locket, and I don't wear chains. So I don't know where he got this from. But today, we are going to do a video about 10 things that they don't tell you about before you become a parent. And these are 10 things that are custom to me or my friend. Shout out to Lachey. She gave me some of these ideas. Kiora, Kiki Lolo. She gave me some of these other ideas. And Anisha, she helped me too. So the first one that I want to say is allergies. Me and Legacy did these. And I put X on here by allergies because they don't tell you that if your child has an allergy, everything that you order, you will pretty much, sorry, I'm hiding his pacifier. You will pretty much have to check the allergy menu, the nutrition menu, the ingredient menu on everything. He has an egg allergy, and you guys know how many things have egg in it. That is one of the hardest allergies I think I've ever come across. The second one is you become an honorary nurse, and the hospital stays, please don't knock the camera over, and the hospital stays that you have for if you have a sick little guy like mine. I did not know I would be in the hospital as much as I was, that I would pretty much be, I moved in. We had like months worth of clothes in there. We had to keep rotating in and out to go and do laundry. We were in that thing. We had noodles. Y'all know when you get some noodles somewhere, you moving in because you got to have your comfort food and popcorn. And so one of the floors, you couldn't even have popcorn. I was like, oh, that's my movie time. And we love watching movies. The third one is babies can sense how you're feeling and what your mood is. And I know this is true, even from before you have your little guy, little girl, they can feel your energy when you're pregnant. So they know when you're sad, they know when you're gloomy, they know when you're happy. I know when I was sad during my pregnancy, this little guy used to always kick, and I felt like that was our close bond of when we always, like, from then on, we was linked because he used to help me when I was sad. And that's really, y'all, it's like so crazy. And for guys, you probably don't get it, but for women who've had children, you know that feeling. Like if you're down and you're a little guy, or that move, that little movement inside of you just lets you know, like, I'm going for them. I'm gonna keep pushing. So yes, they feel that too. And then even outside, when you're holding them and that energy that you're giving off, that's a lot of times why they have the skin to skin contact. Not only are you getting that skin to skin, like they're just warming up knowing you're that bonding, their mom, dad, that's that love, but also they know that vibe, that energy, like they feel you. And so if you sad, angry, frustrated, they're gonna be sad, angry, frustrated. I noticed that, like if I would get frustrated, I would raise my tone, Legacy would start to raise his tone. So I was like, well, he's only doing what he's seeing me do. So I don't want to have a child that's always angry and yelling that you see running around. So I just, you know, say what I got to say, but I say it calmly. But I realized with him, I got to give him the look, because he like me, he is bad. And man, if you, that he'll laugh at you if you say something quietly, or if you just say it nicely, he's like, okay, you thought. So yes, I have to give him that. Don't let me get you. And let's see, the fourth one is you feel like a boss. This one is mainly for my mom. See, I really gotta excuse my nail. I broke this right before, I kid you not. But feel like a boss. And I say this one because when I gave birth, like, yeah, giving birth is crazy, but after you do it, you just like, I did that shit. Like, and then every time I look at my son, I just be like, I pushed, like, that thing came out of me. I carried that big thing, and that big thing came out of me. I don't understand it. It's such a beautiful feeling. But with me, when it comes to if I post something on the internet, or if some of these vlogs I talk about or what I say, I just don't care what people say anymore. Like, the only person who really can judge me and who can who I'm living for is my son. And if my son rocking with it, I'm rocking with it. I don't care what nobody else got to say. Like, you feel like a boss. Nobody can tell you nothing. I have this whole new, or now that he's out the hospital, I have this whole new, I'm focusing on me. I feel like I'm the shit, you know? And it's like, once you do that, you're a super mom. Once your kid is good and you're good and you know you did that, you created life and you got that life going and that life is good. Like, there's no other feeling. I couldn't think of nothing else that's better besides your legacy, what you created, living on and being better. So I feel like a boss just because my kid is a baby boss. Number five, you still have a life. And by that, everybody tell your life is over. You can't do anything. Now, I can't say I don't have as much freedom as I had before. Like, when I could just hop in my car and go, I have to either bring my child with me or make sure my child is with someone. But you still do have a life. I still have friends. I still get to hang out. Now, you may not have some of those same friends, but, and that is another thing. People don't tell you as many friends that you lose, but you still, you got your true friends. They're still there. They become auntie so-and-so, cousin so-and-so. Like, you know, they become that extra help. So you still have a life. I still go out. Like, I'm not just cooped up in the house. And even if you're in the house, you can have mommy play dates. Like, if you find your mommy friends, that's the thing. Like, mommy friends cool too. Y'all might think since we had kids now we're born. No, y'all can have, like, it's just the same amount of fun. It's fun. And then number six is you'll never, ever, ever, ever be 100% ready to have a kid. You will never. And so, I know a lot of people say, oh, I'm going to have one when I'm ready. Stop, baby. I'm going to have one when I'm ready. I don't have to worry about that, you know. Mm-mm. You're not ready. You'll be ready probably. Maybe you think you're ready financially. You're not going to be ready physically, emotionally. Mm-mm. Because it's just nothing that can prepare you for raising a kid. I even helped with my little cousins for years. And shout out Ray L, because I know she asked me if I was going to put her in my video. But yes, I was helping raise, like, had her every weekend. And it still didn't prepare me for having your kid, because you got them 24/7. Let me see, I almost fail, y'all. 24/7. And, like, when they go to sleep, it's not, no, I can take you back to the owner, return the sender. No, you're the sender, so they return it to you. Like, they're yours, and you love them, but they tire you out. And they surely can run your pockets a little slim. But at the same time, you, like, they're a blessing, and you'll never be ready. So I guess you can try to get as ready as you think you can be, but you'll never be 100% ready. And that's something that they don't tell you, because people also always tell you, wait till you're ready to have a kid. Don't have a kid till you're ready. Now, I'm not saying go out there and rush and have one, but you need to tell them when they tell you, I ain't gonna never be ready. But when the time comes, I'm just have to take on my responsibility. Number seven, you're always going to be buying them stuff. You cannot plug that in. Please don't plug that in. And so, yes, it don't matter where I'm at. I'm at Walmart, I'm always buying him some candy, some juice, or shoot, even his essential supplies, some milk. But if I'm shopping for clothes, I'm always looking for him something. I won't buy myself something unless I'm buying him something. And I just don't feel right, because I always feel like a parent should never look better than your child. Never. A parent should never, you know, I'm like, my child is always going to be better than me. I'm not going to be looking crazy, and I'm not going to be looking, you know, horrible, but a child is never, ever going to, you know, I'm not going to put myself over my child. He's first. So always buy him stuff. They don't tell you that. I guess we'll realize that when we ask them to always buy us stuff, but we never. Hold on, guys. Had a little escaper, but we always buy them stuff. So, number eight. This one was a shocker to me. The hospital videos that they tell you to watch at the hospital, those do help. They help. Mainly the purple cry. I will never forget. I sat there, and when I was watching the video, I was just like, why am I watching this? I really don't feel like watching this shit. Like, why do I have to watch this video in order to take my child home? Like, I birthed this child. This is mine. And you're going to tell me I can't leave unless I watch this video. You know you got to do the other stuff too. But watching this video. And when I think about the video, it just kept saying purple cry. Your kid will cry all the way until they're purple, and you will probably want to pull your hair out, lose your mind, and that's where a lot of people shake babies, and they have the shaking baby syndrome. So when my son is crying, and it's to the point that I'm just like, oh, shit, it's getting real. I just sit there and breathe, and I think about that video, and then I think about all the times and all the parents that, like, were stressful, and they couldn't deal with the crying. I'm just like, you know what? This crying is not that bad. There's times when I just let my kids sit there and cry. Really, what I was told in the hospital with my son is crying is not bad. Crying actually helps their lungs when they're little. And so crying is not all that bad. Now, I'm not saying let your child go and holler, scream to the top of their lungs for hours. But I can say that letting them cry a little bit does help. Hey, sometimes you got to just let them breathe it out, and you just breathe and come accustomed to it and just be like, okay. I know Legacy, we'll sit there and just look at each other like, really? This what we gonna do? What you crying for? He don't even know why he would be crying. So, you know, they just gotta cry. Let their little lungs work and you know, grow. It will help you out in the long run. It will keep you from becoming like so stressed and having to just lose your mind. Cause man, those of you know, them cries will get to you. Number 9 is you will miss your kid as soon as you are away from them. Yes. Mm-hmm. I would drop my kid off, leave him with my mama, and I'll be calling her within probably 45 minutes, actually. Maybe an hour, or at least 45 minutes. To be like, mom, what he doing? Is he asleep? Did he cry? Did he eat? Did he drink something? Did he miss me? Did he cry when I went out the door? Like, it's always something. Like, I'm always call and check on him. That's my little booger, my stink butt. And I had number 10, but I guess I didn't bring it in here with me, but I know about her. But number 10 is that they tell you it's hard, but it's not as hard as, you know, you think it's hard. And it's like, yeah, whatever. I got to work hard. I got to stay up, all this extra shit. No, everything is literally hard. literally freaking hard. And you have to make sacrifices. There's some stuff that you might want to go do that you can't bring your kid, or it's not going to benefit your kid. It's not a good place for them to be. And you got to chuck up that L and just be like, dang, you know what? Forget it. It's like, yeah, it's hard. Like raising my son, staying up and all the extra stuff. But what's hard was when my sister went to Mardi Gras and I had to chuck up that L because I had a kid and I didn't have nobody to watch him. I was just like, damn, we talked about this trip and we planned this trip because we had seen Girls Trip and we planned it and all. And now when the trip comes, I got a kid so I can't go. So yes, I was very shitty and that was hard. So yes, it hits you hard in every different way. You never know. And you got to chuck up them L's and make them sacrifices. Her friend Samuels told her, because she came back and told me once they was talking about how I was tripping on the trip, came back and told her, it might have been Kiora too, but that them first couple of years after you have your kid, you got to take them L's and you got to miss out on certain events and certain trips. But, you know, after those trips are over and the older that, like, they get, you can start getting back and more into your life now. Like I said, you still have a life, but the older they get, the more stuff you can go and do because you'll feel more comfortable. So that leads me to number 10. But my bonus one, which is where I always find myself doing it, is your kids will watch cartoons and they will go to sleep. And you'll still find yourself watching those cartoons. Y'all don't know how long I've been sitting and watching Puppy Dog Pals. I know the episodes by heart. I know the parts where they're going to start singing and dancing. I'll be on the phone or on FaceTime. And people will be like, is that the cartoons in the back? And I'm like, yeah. And they're like, ain't your kid asleep? Yeah, I'm sitting here watching it. Or I'll be tuned out and they'll be like, what you watching? Girl, I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm watching Puppy Dog Pals. Shit got real. Bingo and Rolly was on a mission. that is my stuff. It's crazy. You watch them, y'all become big kids together, and you become a big kid by yourself when they go to sleep. But really, it's all great. It's just a bunch of different things that people don't tell you before you have a kid. And having a kid isn't bad, but you know, it's everybody's life. It hits them differently. Some people take the bad, some people take the good. And you know, you just got to make it is what it is, and try to make your kid the best kid as possible. I know I'm trying to raise up a starer, but these things are set to me. Everybody else's might be different. There might be 10 other things that other people... Actually, I won't even say set to me. I'll say set to me and people that I know that I've asked the question about. But everybody may have another 10, another freaking 20, 30 things that people didn't tell you. Some people may feel like they were told everything. You never know. But at least for me, there were some things that I wasn't told that, you know, but you always have to learn things on your own. Everything can't be told and done for you. So I was happy to be able to learn from my child and become a different person, more of an adult, I should say, because I won't say become an adult because I was already grown and an adult, but I became a mom, a better person, trying to become a better role model for him. So I know he's a boy, but at the end of the day, he gonna be looking for a female, so I can't be sitting here acting crazy and looking crazy. And so, you know, yeah, kids make you become the person that if you're not already the kid that you should have been. I mean, not the kid, Jesus. The adult that you should have been. You coming to say bye? I'm finishing it up too. You came perfect timing. Say bye. You been out there eating. Say bye. Bye, guys.
Laid eyes on you when I heard your heartbeat too. Oh, I never knew I could witness an angel so beautiful. From the